Hallelujah. Poderoso. Thank you, Jesus. We worship. We worship you. We praise you, Father. Have your way, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Just waiting for everybody to tune in. Solo estamos esperando que todos entren. Amén. Estamos en vivo. Bendiciones. La paz del Señor sea con cada uno de vosotros. Aleluya, aleluya. Poderoso. God bless everybody. Amen. We're just waiting for everybody to tune in. We're live. God bless everybody that's watching us. Brother Ulises Garcia, God bless you, brother. Stay tuned in, man. The Lord has an awesome word for us. Amen. Just want to wait for everybody that's watching us to go ahead and... Amen. Guadalupe Amaya, bendiciones. Amen. El Señor tiene una palabra. En solo momento estaremos empezando. Amen. Creo que Dios tiene una palabra para cada uno de nosotros. Amen. Dios es bueno. Solo estamos esperando que todos entren allí. Amen. Estamos en vivo. God bless everybody. Ready to start this session. Amen. God is good. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Peace and blessings to everyone that's watching. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise God, praise God. Amen. Thank you all for tuning in. There's a lot of people there. Even if I don't mention your name, got a lot of people tuning in. Amen. God bless you, God bless you. Dios le bendiga, Dios le bendiga. Dios tiene una palabra poderosa para nosotros. Amen. Bueno es el Señor. Bueno es el Señor, para siempre es su misericordia. God is good, God is good. Aleluya, poder de Dios, palabra poderosa. Mis pasos dejo, mis pasos doy, no como el mundo la da. Santo, gracias Dios mío por hablar. Dios te bendiga, siervo, amén. En solo momento estaremos empezando. Creo que el Señor tiene una palabra para nosotros. My peace I give unto you. My peace I leave you. I don't give it like the world giveth. Amen, amen. Thank you everybody that's getting tuned in. God bless you all that are watching. In just moments we're going to be starting. Just waiting for everybody to tune in. Amen. I think the Lord has a powerful, powerful word for us. God is good. Amen. Dios la bendiga. Dios la bendiga. Mary Martinez. Bendiciones. Dios tiene una palabra para nosotros. God has a word prepared for us. In just moments, we're going to be starting. En solo momento estaremos empezando. Amén. Predicar la poderosa palabra de Dios. Dios los bendiga a cada uno de ustedes. Amén. Que nos están viendo, entonizando con nosotros. We're going to be starting in just moments. I think the Lord has a powerful word for us. I've been anticipating for this moment. It's been over a week that we haven't been on here. Amen. Live on radio. I think God has a word for us. Amen. Creo que Dios tiene una palabra para nosotros. En solo momentos estaremos empezando. Amen. Les agradezco su tiempo. Solo estamos esperando que todos entren allí. Amen. Para empezar en esta estación de radio y podcast. Amen. Amen, sister Denise Paris. Asking for prayer. Please keep my daughters in prayer. Amen, sister. Amen. We'll definitely be praying. Amen. That God does a great work in their lives. Asking that God can do a work in them. Lift them up. I feel the Holy Spirit. La hermana aquí, Denise Pérez, pidiendo oración por sus hijas. Amen. Que Dios haga la obra. Amen. Que Dios sea allí. Yo no las conozco. Pero sé que Dios las conoce. Amén. Y Dios escucha la oración. La oración eficaz del justo puede mucho. The prayer of the just availeth much, is what the Bible says. Amen. We're going to be praying. God bless everybody. I think we're ready to start. You know, everybody's tuned in and showing love and respect. And I think we're Just about ready to begin preaching the good word of the Lord. Amen. I love you in the Lord, everybody that's tuned in. God bless you. We'll be starting in just moments. We're just waiting for everybody to tune in. We'll be praying for Paula and Faith. We'll be praying, amen. God has a plan for their lives, amen. Thank you, everybody that's tuned in to this radio and podcast station. In just moments, we're going to begin preaching the word of God. In just moments. En solo momentos empezaremos con esta hermosa palabra que el Señor ha puesto en mi corazón. Amen. I feel the presence of God. Praise God. We got some prayer warriors right there watching. Amen. Praise the Lord. That's what I'm talking about, man. God he's building up an army, amen, of prayer. Amen. Of prayer warriors. We'll be beginning in just moments. We're going to go ahead and dive in. Just waiting for everybody to tune in. I believe God has a word for us. Amen. Definitely going live. God is good. God is good. Amen. I think we're ready to go. We'll be praying. Amen. Sister, pray for Wilbur and Angelica. Amen. We're praying. Father God, do a work in their lives. Father, let your will be done, Lord Jesus. You are holy and you, Father God, you hear our prayers. David said in Psalms 64, it says, O you who hears prayer, O you who hears prayer. He knew that God would listen to his prayer. God is the one that hears our prayers. Amen. Dijo el salmista, amén, en el Salmo 64, si no me confundo, le dijo al Señor, tú que escuchas la oración. Él elevaba su oración al Señor sabiendo, amén, que le hay, creyendo que le hay. Hay que creerle al Señor, amén. El Señor es bueno. En solo momento estaremos empezando, amén. We'll be beginning in just a couple moments, just waiting for everybody to tune in. Praise God. God bless everybody. Jenny Rodriguez, Maynor Hernandez, amen. Daniel Swedjart, God bless you. You know, thank you everybody for tuning in. The Lord has a word for us, amen, that the Lord has put in our hearts. Amen. We thank God. I think I'm ready to go ahead and dive in. Amen. We're ready to begin this session. So let's go ahead and dive into the word of God. Amen. And everybody go ahead and amen. Praise God. That's right. 2 Chronicles 7:14. That's what my brother Ulises Garcia, what he commented. Amen. If my people, look, Holy Ghost. If my people who are called by my name would humble themselves. If I'm not mistaken, I think that's the one. Ahí está el hermano Ulises García comentando, 2 Crónicas 7:14. Si no me equivoco, dice, si mi pueblo, al que yo llamo por nombre, se humillare y buscare mi rostro, yo su tierra sanaré. Amén. Creo que ahí, amén. Ahí me confirman que esa es. Amén. Hay que saber, estudiar la escritura, saber, conocer la palabra de Dios. We gotta know the word of God. Amen. That's definitely the scripture right there. Praise God. Let's go ahead and dive in. Amen. We'll go ahead and get into the word of God. Thank you for everybody that's tuned in, man. I love you in the Lord. Got a lot of people, man, watching this right now. Share this video. Somebody needs to hear a word from the Lord. Amen. Compartan este video, amén. Les agradezco a todos los que están entonizando. Ya vamos a empezar a entrar a la palabra del Señor. No sé de dónde nos visitan, amén. Me gustaría que ahí comentaran de dónde nos visitan, desde dónde, ciudad, país, amén. Sabemos que hemos tenido gente desde Ecuador, Argentina, México, amén, de otros estados en los Estados Unidos, amén, que han entonizado con nosotros. I know there's a lot of people that have tuned in from different countries, from Argentina, Ecuador. Amen. Mexico, different states in the U.S. Go ahead and comment, you know, feel free, share this video. And I think God has a word for us today. Amen. Let's go ahead and dive in. West Covina, California. God bless you, Sister Ernestina. Go ahead and share this video. Amen. God is good. We're going to go ahead and dive in. Chicago, Illinois. We're praying for Chicago, man. You know, praying for Austin, Texas. Amen. We're praying for all these states, amen. And the enemy's out there like a roaring lion looking to whom, you know, for whom to devour, amen. But we're more than conquerors in Jesus Christ. Somos más que vencedores en Cristo Jesús. Y con eso dicho, vamos a entrar a la palabra. With that being said, we're going to go ahead and dive in. Thank you for everybody that's tuned in, amen. Barksdale, Louisiana, Amen, my brother. Praying for our cities, amen, and believing that God is he's doing the work, amen. He's reaching out. We believe we're living in the end times, and God is definitely, he's definitely on the move, amen. With that being said, we're gonna go ahead and dive into the word of the Lord, amen. God is good. God is good, amen. Praise God. Oh yeah, we got time. We have time, amen. Thank God. Praise the Lord. Praise God, praise God. Amen. God bless everybody. I want to welcome you into this God of Wonders Holy Life Radio and Podcast Station. Queremos darle la bienvenida a cada uno de los que nos están escuchando, amén, alrededor del mundo, alrededor de la nación, amén. Queremos darle la bienvenida a esta estación de radio y podcast. Radio Dios de Proezas, Vida Santa, amén. Ya estamos en vivo, amén. Ahí hay mucha gente entonizando con nosotros por medio en vivo, por medio de Facebook también, amén. Creo que el Señor tiene una palabra poderosa preparada para cada uno de nosotros. Yo creo que el Señor ha sido bueno con nosotros y nos ha bendecido, amén. Nos ha dado la dicha de poder, aleluya, escuchar su palabra. Y de poder, amén, aleluya, gozar de su palabra en los tiempos que estamos viviendo. I think that the Lord has bestowed upon us a beautiful, beautiful blessing, amen, to be able to read his word, to understand his word, and be able to preach the message, amen, of the Lord Jesus Christ, amen. For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ, Paul said, for it is the power unto salvation to everyone that believeth, to the Jew first and then to the Greek. Porque no me avergüenzo del evangelio, porque es poder de Dios, dijo Pablo el apóstol, primeramente para el judío y luego para el griego. Aleluya, es poder de Dios. El evangelio es poder de Dios. The gospel is power unto salvation. Power. Aleluya. And we just thank God for this opportunity. Amen. This is your brother in Christ, humble servant, Brother Tony Vasquez Jr. Amén. Este es su hermano y servidor, Tony Vasquez Jr. Amén. Y les agradezco por entonizar con nosotros en este día. Estoy muy agradecido. Amén. Aleluya, el Señor es bueno. Gracias por todos los que están allí comentando, amén, entonizando con nosotros por medio de Facebook Live, amén. Creo que el Señor tiene una palabra poderosa para nosotros. Yo meditaba, acabamos de salir de, amén, de un estudio bíblico, amén. Estábamos en la casa de unos hermanos, amén, y aquí en la ciudad de Richmond, California, donde nos tiene el Señor en este momento. Y el Señor nos daba una palabra poderosa, amén. Y creo que Dios tiene una palabra para nosotros. Yo venía meditando después que nos vinimos de ese lugar, amén. Y el Señor me daba una palabra, amén. Y creo que es importante poder entender la palabra del Señor y saber y entender cuando el Espíritu Santo nos da una palabra para compartir con alguien. I think it's very important, amen. We just got out of a Bible study here in the city of Richmond, California. Amen. And after the Bible study, you know, I was driving home with my wife and kids, and I was meditating. You know, the Holy Spirit put a word in my heart. And I think it's very important for us to be able to know, understand, and discern when the Holy Spirit, amen, wants to speak to us. God bless everybody that's watching us. Brother Joaquin, hey, God bless you, my brother. Love you, man. Everybody that's tuned in, share this video, man. I think that God has a word for somebody. We're getting ready to dive into the Word of God. Amen. Dios bendiga a cada uno de los que nos están viendo en vivo ahorita. Creo que Dios tiene una palabra para ti. Estamos aquí en esta estación de radio y podcast. Radio Dios de Proezas, Vida Santa. Amén. Gracias por todos los que nos están viendo allí. Y sin quitar más tiempo, vamos a entrar a la palabra del Señor. Without further ado, we're going to go ahead and dive into the Word of God. Amen. And God bless everybody. Sister Nancy Henriquez commenting. Amen. Live blessings. Thank you, sister. Go ahead and comment, you know, a prayer request. Amen. We'll be sharing the Word of God and we'll be praying because first and foremost, this radio station, amen, God has put it in our hearts to be able to serve and to give back, amen, to supply your needs, amen. Dios nos ha dado este medio, amen, primeramente para edificar al pueblo, amen, y poder, aleluya, suplir su necesidad espiritual, amen. Para eso estamos aquí, amen. Y sin quitar más tiempo, vamos a entrar a la palabra del Señor, amen. Dios es bueno para siempre, su misericordia. The Lord is good, his mercy endureth forever, amen. We're going to go ahead and go into the book of Psalms, amen. If you don't have a Bible, have no fear, amen. I'll be reading the word of God, amen. If you do have a Bible, you have it on your phone, or you have a physical copy, wherever you are, some of you may be at work, some of you may be on the go, amen. But God, you know, wants us to be in one accord, amen. That's what God called us to do. Si tiene su Biblia, amén, allí puede compartir conmigo, amén. Si es una copia física o por su teléfono, amén. Dios quiere que estemos en comunión, en unidad, amén, en un solo sentir, amén. Y pero si no la tiene, no se preocupe, aquí tenemos la palabra poderosa del Señor. Y vamos a empezar, amén, aleluya. Voy a estar abriendo la palabra poderosa del Señor en el libro de Salmos, capítulo 91. We'll be opening up the word of God in the book of Psalms, chapter 91, amen. God is good, God is good. We'll be doing this bilingual today. Estaremos haciendo esto en bilingüe, amén. Yo creo que el Señor tiene una palabra para nosotros, amén. Estaré leyendo primero en español y luego en inglés, amén, para que todos puedan compartir de esta hermosa palabra de Dios. Y como decía un siervo muy conocido, siervo de Dios que predicaba la palabra del Señor, me gusta siempre empezar, amén, antes de leer la palabra, voz de Dios grabada en papel, aleluya. And like a great man of God said before that I highly esteem, amen, that he preached the gospel for so many years, amen, led of the Spirit. Before he read the word, I want to do as well and say the same thing he said. Voice of God recorded on paper. Praise God. Can you believe that? The voice of God recorded on paper. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Thank you for everybody that's tuned in. We're going to go ahead and dive in. Psalms 91, verse 1 and on. Salmo 91, versículo 1 en adelante. La palabra del Señor se lee en nombre del Padre, del Hijo y con la bendición de su Santo Espíritu. The word of God is read in the name of the Father, the name of the Son, and with the blessing of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Y dice la palabra de Dios. El que habita al abrigo del Altísimo morará bajo la sombra del Omnipotente. Diré yo a Jehová, esperanza mía y castillo mío, mi Dios en quien confiaré. Yo siento la unción del Señor. Él te librará del lazo del cazador, de la peste destructora. Con sus plumas te cubrirá, y debajo de sus alas estarás seguro. Escudo y adarga es su verdad. Amen. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God. In him will I trust. Surely he shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. Let us pray. Oramos. Padre Santo, Espíritu Santo de Dios, Padre Eterno, admirable, Consejero, te exaltamos. Eres bienvenido a este lugar, Espíritu Santo. Holy Spirit, you are welcome into this place. Take control of this session, Father God. Let it be you speaking to these people that are watching, these people that are listening, Father, your children and those that do not know you, Father. Speak to them. Háblale a todo aquel, Dios mío, que te está escuchando, que está escuchando esta estación de radio y podcast, Dios mío. Háblales, Dios mío santo. Allí donde se encuentra alrededor del mundo, tú tienes una palabra para ellos. Espíritu Santo, toma control, Dios mío. Tú eres el que habla. Que seas tú, Dios mío, hablando. No te pido que me quites, Dios mío, sino que me pongas como un vaso útil, Dios mío, para dar tu palabra. Father God, have your way and bless your word. Speak to somebody right now, Father. In the mighty name of Yeshua, we pray, Father, and we thank you. Amen and amen. Gracias, Señor. El que habita al abrigo del Altísimo morará bajo la sombra del Omnipotente. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Of the Almighty, El Shaddai. La palabra omnipotente en el antiguo hebreo quiere decir El Shaddai, que básicamente se traduce omnipotente, Dios Todopoderoso. The word Almighty in the ancient language of the Hebrew, amen, is the word El Shaddai, which means Almighty, All-Powerful, God, Dios Todopoderoso, el Dios que va delante de mí como poderoso gigante, the God that goes before me like a mighty warrior. ¿Por qué el Señor nos trae esta palabra en este día? Why is God speaking to us, amen, through this passage today? Porque el Espíritu Santo me dice que hay muchos batallando con el temor. Hay mucho pueblo de Dios, mucha gente que no tiene paz, que se le hace difícil confiar en Dios al 100%. Because the Spirit of God is speaking to us and telling us there's a lot of people out there facing, struggling with fear, struggling with deceit. Amen. The enemy trying to have you bound. Amen, trying to make you lose your focus from trusting in the Almighty God. Aleluya, Dios viene hablándonos por medio de esta palabra. Porque lo que Dios quiere es que empecemos como pueblo de Dios, amén, a confiar en Él. What God wants from His people is that we begin to trust in Him, trust in His word, confiar en su palabra, amén. Porque a veces es bien fácil, amén, decirlo, hablar los pasajes de la Biblia, amén, pero se hace más difícil creer lo que estamos leyendo, lo que estamos diciendo. A lot of times it's so easy for us to quote scripture and say this, this and that, amen, but it is difficult for us to actually believe and trust in God's word. And the Lord begins to speak to us and confirm His word. El Señor nos habla por medio de su palabra. Amén, el salmista que pasó tantas pruebas, luchas en su vida, amén. Aquí podemos ver un hombre, amén, conforme al corazón de Dios, pero también un hombre que pasó las mismas batallas que yo y tú estamos pasando. We see a man of God writing a letter of the Holy Ghost, Psalm 91, amen, writing this psalm unto the Lord with his heart. A man after the God's own heart, amen. But also a man that also went through the same trials and tribulations, faced the same situations and problems that me and you faced. The word of God is evident. The word of God convicts us, speaks to us, and gives us truth. Amen. The word of God guides us. The word of God comforts us. La palabra del Señor, aleluya, nos conforta, nos da paz y gozo. Pero es necesario empezar a creer lo que dice su palabra. Mire, mi hermano, si yo no hubiese creído lo que esta palabra dice, el enemigo hace mucho tiempo ya me hubiera destruido. If I wouldn't believe what this word of God says, brothers and sisters, the enemy would have been had his way with me. Oh, but I thank God that through the faith, amen, through faith in Him, believing in His word, amen, I am able to say, hallelujah, that God is with me and I am still in the Lord's path. Amen. Por medio de la fe puedo decir amén, ebenecer, ebenecer. Hasta aquí Dios me ha ayudado. Por medio de la fe, por medio de su palabra. El que habita, aleluya, al abrigo del Altísimo morará bajo la sombra del Omnipotente. Esa palabra, amén, sombra en el original lenguaje hebreo quiere decir un escondedero. Aleluya, that word right there, abide under the shadow of the Almighty. In the original Hebrew text, amen, is referring to a secret place. As long as you are connected to the vine, as long as you're seeking God, as long as you're praying every day, reading your word, you're dwelling under the shadow of the Almighty. You are hiding under His wings. Mientras tú sigas, amén, cada día diario buscando al Señor en oración, en lectura de la palabra, amén, buscando al Señor, amén, en tu vida personal, devocional, dándole tiempo conectado a la viña. Mientras tú hagas eso, quiero decirte, aleluya, que podrás resistir y seguir, amén, habitando, morando bajo la sombra del Omnipotente. Pero para eso es necesario, queridos hermanos y hermanas, buscar al Señor de todo corazón, ser hacedores de su palabra y no solo oidores. It is necessary, important for us to be doers of the word and not just hearers of the word. Holy Spirit, without faith, it is impossible to please God. Dice el Espíritu Santo, sin fe es imposible agradar a Dios. Para esto, para poder creer esta palabra, se requiere un paso de fe. To be able to believe what the Word of God says, it is important. Hallelujah. It is necessary for us, brothers and sisters, to believe by faith. Believe by faith what it says. When the enemy wants to attack you with fear, with lies, with temptations, hallelujah, the word of God is telling you to dwell under the shadow of the Almighty. Cuando el enemigo viene contra ti con luchas, tribulaciones, tentaciones, el Espíritu te dice que es tiempo de leer la palabra, aplicarla, porque dice, el que habita al abrigo del Altísimo morará bajo la sombra del Omnipotente. Espíritu Santo, versículo 10. Dice, aleluya, del Salmo 91, dice, no te sobrevendrá mal, ni plaga tocará tu morada. The word of God says in verse 10 of the same Psalm 91, there shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any plague come near to thy dwelling. But it is time for us to get connected to the vine. Aleluya, conéctate a la viña, cree en su palabra, aleluya, porque la Biblia dice que el temor tiene tormento, because the word of God says that fear hath torment, aleluya, but God's perfect love casts all fear, pero el perfecto amor de Dios echa fuera todo el temor, pero es necesario empezar a creer su palabra, porque Dios va delante de ti, como dice la palabra del Señor, aleluya, y si por los ríos tú pasarás, por el fuego no te quemará, dice, ni la plaga, como dice la palabra, dice, y la llama arderá en ti, porque yo soy tu Salvador. Amén, así lo dice la palabra. Es tiempo de creer lo que la palabra del Señor dice. It is time for us to believe what the word of God says, amen, because it is important that we begin to follow after God's word with faith. Por medio de la fe, los antiguos pudieron hacer grandes cosas. It is through faith that the men of ancient, the ancient men of the Bible, that they were able to do wonderful and marvelous things. Amen. And God wants to do the same in our lives. Amen. God wants to do the same in our lives. He wants to reveal Himself to us. Amen. Because it is through faith, it is by faith alone, amen, that we are more than conquerors. Amen. God is good and His mercy endures forever. Aleluya, santo es el Señor, amén. Quiero llevarte al libro de Segunda de Crónicas, capítulo 20. I want to take you to the Word of God, the Old Testament, 2 Chronicles, chapter 20. Amen. And we'll be reading on. You can follow along. Amen. I think God is speaking to us. Creo que el Señor nos está hablando. Amén. Y nos está revelando su palabra. Dios está contigo. Él dijo en su palabra, nunca te dejaré ni te desampararé. Pero dice el Espíritu Santo, tú eres el que me has dejado. Tú eres el que me desamparas cuando no me buscas en oración. Listen to what the Holy Spirit is telling you. Jesus said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. But it is you that has left me. It is you that has forsaken me. You're not seeking me. You're not trying to talk to me, saith the Lord. What's happening to your prayer life? I want to hear from you. I want to speak to you. I want to show you great and mighty things, says the Lord. But it is time for us, amen, to get reconnected and to believe in God's word. Es tiempo, querido hermano, querida hermana. El Señor es bueno. I want to go ahead and read this passage because the word of God has a beautiful teaching for us, amen, through this beautiful passage, amen. El Señor tiene una hermosa palabra, amen. Gracias por todos los que están entonizando y viéndonos en vivo. God bless everybody that's watching us, amen. Live, share this video with somebody on your page, your friend. Somebody needs to hear this word. Alguien tiene que escuchar esta palabra. Compártela, amen. En este pasaje vamos a ver qué poderoso es cuando uno se somete al Señor. Cuando uno busca al Señor en medio de las tribulaciones, de las pruebas, amén. En medio de todo lo que el enemigo quiere. Hay momentos donde el enemigo viene, dice la palabra del Señor. Aunque el enemigo venga, aleluya, como río, el Espíritu de Dios levantará bandera por vosotros. The word of God says, hallelujah, though the enemy comes in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord will raise up a standard against him. Hallelujah. He who dwells in the secret place, el que habita en ese lugar, aleluya, ese lugar secreto, aleluya, morará bajo la sombra del Omnipotente, shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Praise the Lord. Amén. Segunda de Crónicas, capítulo 20, versículo 1 en adelante. Pasadas estas cosas, aconteció que los hijos de Moab y de Amón, y con ellos otros de los amonitas, vinieron contra Josafat a la guerra. Josafat siendo el rey de Jerusalén, amén. Pueblo de Dios, versículo 2, y acudieron algunos y dieron aviso a Josafat diciendo, contra ti viene una gran multitud del otro lado del mar y de Siria, y he aquí están en Asesón Tamar, que es en Agadi. Fíjense cómo el enemigo quiere traer y poner temor en el pueblo de Dios, aún en el ungido de Dios. 2 Chronicles chapter 20, verse 1 and 4. It came to pass after this also that the children of Moab and the children of Ammon, and with them other beside the Ammonites, came against Jehoshaphat to battle. Jehoshaphat, the king in Jerusalem, amen, God's people. Verse 2, then there came some that told Jehoshaphat, saying, there cometh a great multitude against thee from beyond the sea on this side, Syria. And behold, they be in Hazazon Tamar, which is in Gedi. See how the enemy's trying to put fear into the man of God, amen? That's what the enemy does a lot of times. Es lo que el enemigo hace en muchas ocasiones. Quiere poner temor en tu vida, diciendo que no podrás levantarte, diciéndote, aleluya, mentiras del diablo que quieren cuando viene el desánimo. That's how the enemy sometimes creeps in, wants to put fear in your life, wants to tell you that God will never lift you up, wants to tell you that you're a failure, hallelujah. There's something that I read one time that's so beautiful that a lot of times the accuser comes and tries to remind you of your past. But when he does that, just remind him of his future. Praise God. Hallelujah. We all know who wins in the last book of this Bible. We win. The Lord Jesus Christ wins. We're on the winning team. Praise the Lord. Hay un dicho que yo vi una vez, amén, donde dice una parábola por allí, amén, dijo que a veces el enemigo viene y quiere acusarte. Si el enemigo viene y te acusa de tu pasado, recuérdale a él ¿Cuál será su futuro? Aleluya. Poderoso es el Señor, porque todos sabemos qué pasa al final de este libro. Poderoso es el Señor. Ganamos. Estamos en el equipo ganador, porque Cristo es nuestro Rey y Dios. Poderoso es el Señor. Seguimos. Let us continue. Verse 3, 2 Chronicles chapter 20. Aleluya, hay poder. Segunda de Crónicas capítulo 20, versículo 3. Dice la palabra del Señor: entonces Josafat tuvo temor y se humilló su rostro para consultar a Jehová. La primera cosa buena, el primer paso bueno que hizo Josafat, e hizo pregonar ayuno a todo Judá. Amén, ahí está la clave. Verse 3, and Jehoshaphat feared and set himself to seek the Lord. That's the first right step that he did. And he proclaimed the fast throughout all of Judah. Praise God. That's what we need to do. We need to return to the old paths, the ancient teachings that we were taught. Fasting and prayer. There is power in fasting. There is power in prayer. Tenemos que regresar a la senda antigua. Hay poder. Aleluya. Lo que nos enseñaron desde pequeño ya no se ve en la iglesia. Ya no se está predicando sobre el ayuno, sobre la consagración. We're living in a time where the modern day church does not preach about fasting and prayer anymore. We need to return to those old customs that we were taught since we were children. Aleluya, regresar a la senda antigua, donde está el buen camino, to the old paths where the good way is, fasting and prayer. That's where we're empowered by God's Spirit. Ahí es donde el Señor nos embiste de su poder. Aleluya, ¿cuántos lo creemos? Yo lo creo, amén. Es tiempo. Aleluya, versículo 4. Y se reunieron los de Judá para pedir socorro al Señor. Aleluya, es lo que tenemos que hacer, amén. Y también de todas las ciudades de Judá vinieron a pedir ayuda a el Señor. Praise God. And Judah gathered themselves together to ask help of the Lord. Even out of all the cities of Judah, they came to seek the Lord. God is good. God is good. God is good. Dios es bueno. Amén. Es tiempo, aleluya, de que empecemos a confiar en Dios. Aquí mire qué bonito que en los tiempos antiguos estos hombres de Dios, aleluya, en medio de las tribulaciones, en medio de las pruebas, sabían, entendían que era necesario acudir al Dios Todopoderoso, al Dios que es poderoso, majestuoso, al Dios, aleluya, poderoso, guerrero, aleluya, el guerrero que no conoce la derrota. Hay poder en su nombre. Es necesario buscar, acercarnos a Él creyendo que le hay. It is time for us, aleluya, to believe in God's word, to believe and seek. It's how beautiful it is that we read in these ancient times, thousands of years ago, amen, that these men, hallelujah, consecrated themselves to God when trials and tribulation, when fear would come upon them. Let me tell you something, that they started to seek God. They started to go, they went back, amen, to seek the Lord's face, because they understood that God is omnipotent, God is omnipresent, the all-powerful for God. They started to seek His face, the mighty warrior, hallelujah, the God of the heavens and the earth, the God that does not know defeat. That is our God. I want to encourage you today. Our God is mighty and powerful. Quiero animarte hoy. Dios es todopoderoso, aleluya. El Dios de nosotros no es un Dios cualquiera, no es un, aleluya, un monito allí como esas muchas estatuas que tienen. Our God is a powerful God. He's not a little God. He's not like those statues, amen, that the Bible says they have hands but they cannot touch. They have eyes, Holy Spirit, I feel your presence, God. They have eyes but they cannot see. They have mouths but they cannot talk. Son dioses vanos y falsos. Tienen manos pero no pueden tocar. Tienen ojos, aleluya, pero no pueden ver. Tienen manos, aleluya, aleluya. Tienen boca, pero no pueden hablar. Dice la palabra del Señor. El Dios de los dioses de las otras naciones, aleluya, son falsos. Pero Jehová creó los cielos y la tierra. The word of God says that the gods of the other nations are false. They are there. Oh, but the Lord of hosts, but the Lord of hosts, I feel his presence. But the Lord of hosts created the heavens and the earth. It is time for us to begin to trust in his word, to hide under the shadow of the Almighty. The word of God says, with his feathers, under his pinions, he shall cover you. Aleluya, dice la palabra del Señor. Con sus plumas, él te cubrirá. Aleluya, aleluya. Dios es bueno, es Dios todopoderoso. Quiero leerte aquí mismo el versículo 17 de segunda de Crónicas, capítulo 20, dice, aleluya, y el Señor les habló. Hay poder, mira qué poderosa palabra. Y vino palabra del Señor a Josafat y al pueblo. Y el Señor les dice, no habrá necesidad de que peleéis vosotros en este caso. Paraos, estad quietos y ved la salvación. Hay poder, Rabasaya. Oh, dice la palabra. Y ved la salvación de Jehová con vosotros. Oh, Judá y Jerusalén, no temáis ni desmayéis. Salid mañana contra ellos, porque Jehová estará con vosotros. Qué poderosa palabra que Dios habló y Dios te está hablando. I want to read verse 17. From this same chapter 20 of 2 Chronicles, praise the Lord. And the Lord, and the word of the Lord came unto Jehoshaphat and to the people. And he said, there is no need that ye go out and fight in this battle. He said, get yourselves, stand still, and see the salvation of the Lord with you, O Judah and Jerusalem. Fear not, fear not, fear not. Everyone that's watching and listening, the Lord is telling you, fear not. Los que están escuchando, el Señor te dice, no temáis. Fear not, nor be dismayed. Tomorrow go out against them, for the Lord will be with you. Thee, for the Lord will be with thee, for the Lord is with you, porque Dios está contigo, pero es tiempo de que creas a su palabra. Es tiempo, aleluya, de caminar por fe y no por vista. It is time for us to walk by faith and not by sight. It is only through the word of God. This is how we gather up faith. This builds up our faith. The word of God builds up our faith. Así es como el Señor aumenta nuestra fe, por medio de su poderosa palabra. Dice la palabra del Señor, echando pues todas vuestras ansiedad sobre él, porque él tiene cuidado sobre vosotros. The Holy Spirit is speaking. The word of God says, hallelujah, cast your burdens and cares and anxieties upon the Lord, for he careth for you. The Lord is speaking to his people. Dios le habla, está hablando a su pueblo, y también le está hablando a todos aquellos que no le conocen. Tu creador te está hablando y te dice, vuelve a mí, acércate a mí, y yo me acercaré a ti. Yo quiero quitarte esa adicciones, yo quiero quitarte esos temores, esa depresión que te atormenta, esa opresión que te atormenta, ese insomnio que te atormenta. Yo quiero quitarte todo eso. Cristo dijo, aleluya, mi yugo es fácil de llevar. Dijo, aprended de mí que soy fácil. Aleluya, mi yugo es fácil, que soy manso. Aleluya, dice la palabra. The Lord is calling you. You that are struggling with addictions. All you that are. The Lord is speaking to his people. And he's even speaking to those that don't know him. God is calling you. God, your creator from in the heavens and the earth. He's calling you. Amen. And he wants you, hallelujah, to draw near to him. And he will draw near to you. God is calling you. God is telling you, I want to take away your addictions. I want to take away your oppressions. I want to take away that depression that oppresses you. I want to take away all those fears, all that insomnia, all those demonic attacks. I want to take them away, but draw near to me, and I will draw near to you, saith the Lord. Así dice el Señor, acercaos a mí, y yo me acercaré a vosotros. Dios está allí siempre, confiadamente, aleluya. Tenemos que creer en su palabra, acercarnos a él, creyendo que le hay. We gotta draw near to him, believing that we will find in him. But it is necessary for us, hallelujah, to trust in his word. The word of God says that the disciples, hallelujah, Holy Ghost, I feel your presence. Flow, Holy Spirit, flow. Fluye Espíritu Santo. The word of God says, hallelujah, that the disciples, as they were communing with the Lord, hallelujah, they were asking him for faith. They were asking the Lord for faith. And he said, draw near to me. And Jesus said, I am the one that gives faith. And they said, Lord, help mine unbelief. Help my unbelief. Los discípulos en comunión hablando con Cristo, aleluya, reconociendo que les faltaba más fe, le dijeron al Señor, aleluya, ayuda mi incredulidad, ayuda nuestra incredulidad, enséñanos cómo creer, porque solo por medio de su palabra que podemos empezar a alimentar nuestra fe. It is only through the word of God that we can continue to feed, that we can begin to feed our faith, that we can continue, amen, to start believing what his word says, because the passages are here. The word of God is right before us. We have a Bible. Some of you, man, the Holy Spirit is telling me that your Bible is collecting dust. And Jesus is telling you, study the scriptures. Pick up your word. I want to speak to you. Some of you out there saying, God doesn't speak to me. I don't hear his voice. But your Bible is sitting like this, collecting dust. Oh, muchos están allí. Muchos que se quejan y dicen, a mí Dios no me habla. Yo no puedo, no escucho su voz. Pero tu Biblia, dice el Espíritu Espíritu Santo, está empolvada. Dios te dice, yo quiero hablarte, pero tienes, es necesario escudriñar mi palabra, porque por medio de ella podrás escuchar mi voz. Por medio de ella podemos, aleluya, entender lo que su palabra dice. Es por medio de su palabra que conocemos estos pasajes poderosos. Says he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Almighty shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Hallelujah. But how can we be familiar with these passages if we're not reading his word? Pero cómo vamos a poder alimentarnos por medio de estos pasajes si no los conocemos? Holy Spirit, I feel your presence. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Hallelujah. He leadeth me, hallelujah, through green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restoreth my soul. El Señor es mi pastor, nada me faltará. Aleluya, es necesario conocer su palabra, es necesario entender, porque Dios te quiere bendecir, Dios quiere darte paz, y paz que sobrepasa todo entendimiento. God wants to give you peace, and a peace that surpasses all understanding. True peace, true joy. Dios quiere darte verdadera paz, verdadero gozo, pero es necesario que nos acerquemos a él confiadamente, habitar bajo el abrigo del Altísimo. Dios mío santo, te exaltamos, te glorificamos. Amén. Ahora puedo entender por qué el salmista quería habitar. Por eso el salmista dijo, aleluya, dijo, una cosa he demandado a Jehová. Fíjese que dijo demandado. Una cosa yo he demandado, quiero, aleluya, dice, a Jehová, dice, esta buscaré, esta buscaré. Hay que aprender a buscar, aleluya, a buscar ese lugar secreto para poder habitar bajo la sombra del Omnipotente. Dice, esta buscaré, aleluya, que esté yo en la casa de Jehová todos los días de mi vida, para contemplar la hermosura de Jehová, para inquirir en su templo. This is beautiful, this is powerful, amen. God is good and his mercy endureth forever. God is speaking to us. God is giving us a powerful word. Amen. We're believing what the word of God says. We're believing, amen. Hallelujah. That's why I imagine that the psalmist, amen, he said it. Hallelujah. In Psalms 27 verse 4, he said, one thing have I desired of the Lord. He said, one thing have I desired of the Lord. That will I seek after. He said, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. Because he knows that in that secret place, amen, he desired it. That's the only place where we will find refuge. The only place where we will find true peace and satisfaction, security in the Lord. Es el único lugar donde podremos, aleluya, encontrar la paz, seguridad en el Señor. Amén. God is good. God is good. We're believing in what his word says. We're believing that God is speaking to us, speaking to his people, reaching out to those that do not know the Lord. He wants you to experience what it is to dwell in safety. You will keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed upon thee. Hallelujah. The word of God is beautiful. Dice la palabra del Señor. Hallelujah. Dios quiere darte seguridad. Hay muchos que no conocen al Señor. Hallelujah. Como su personal salvador. Hallelujah. Y el Señor, aleluya, quiere que experimentes, que sientas lo que es habitar bajo la sombra del Omnipotente. Amén. Por medio de su palabra, por medio de la fe, amén, por medio de la oración, podremos entender, aleluya, lo que es seguir a Dios. Aleluya. Guardar nuestra salvación con temor y temblor. Through God's word, it is through God's word that we'll be able, amen, to understand what God is telling us. And we will be able, hallelujah, to guard our salvation with fear and trembling. But that's why it is so important that we have our devotional life, amen, secure. Amen, that we're seeking God every day, always making time for God. The Bible says, seek him while he is yet to be found. That's why a lot of times temptations and tribulations and fear and all these things that the enemy throws at us, sometimes it is difficult for us to surpass, because we don't have a strong prayer life. We don't have a strong, hallelujah, devotional life. Amen. We're lacking faith. You're lacking faith because you are not feeding your faith with the word of God. You're not feeding your faith. Amen. You're not, hallelujah, through prayer. Amén. Por eso a veces se nos hacen difíciles las tribulaciones, amén, las situaciones, las circunstancias, cuando el enemigo viene contra nosotros, amén, cuando batallamos con nuestra carne, a veces es difícil poder sobrepasar eso. Pero es simple, mi hermano, es porque no tenemos una vida devocional, una vida de oración, de escudriñarla, amén, una vida de estudio, de lectura de la palabra del Señor. Por eso a veces se nos hace difícil poder, aleluya, sobrepasar esa lucha. Cuando Dios nos dice que, aleluya, que Él va delante de nosotros como poderoso gigante. Aleluya, que Él pelea por nosotros. When the Lord is telling us that He goes before us like a mighty warrior, like His word says, that He fights, hallelujah, for us. The word of God says, stand firm, for the battle is not ours, it is the Lord's. Dice la palabra del Señor, estad quietos y firmes, porque la batalla no es de vosotros, la batalla es del Señor. Él pelea por nosotros, amén. Pero a veces nosotros queremos pelear con nuestras propias fuerzas. A lot of times we want to fight these battles with our own strength, when God is telling you, stand firm in my word, believe what my word says. Dios te dice, aleluya, estad quietos. Dios te dice, aleluya, párate firme en mi palabra. Aleluya, creer lo que su palabra dice. Amen. It is time for us to return, amen, to the old standards in which we were taught, amen, to seek God day and night. Hallelujah. Like Psalms 5 says, give ear to my words, O Lord. Consider my meditation. Hearken unto the voice of my cry. My King and my God, hallelujah, oh you who hears prayer. El Señor dice el Salmo 5, amén, dice aquí la palabra, escucha, oh Jehová, mis palabras, considera mi gemir. Tú que escuchas la oración, Dios siempre está allí con su oído presto, aleluya, pero a veces nosotros somos los que no hacemos el esfuerzo para buscar a Dios más como es necesario. God is always there with a willing ear, amen, to hear us. So he's waiting for us every day for us to talk to him. Hallelujah. He's supposed to be our faithful friend. He's supposed to be your best friend. Hallelujah. He that does not fail you. The faithful friend. Hallelujah. He's supposed to be our everything. But why do we keep acting like he's the least of our concern nowadays? Even in the body of Christ, we're not giving God the time necessary. We're not giving time, amen, to hear his voice, to hear his word. Hemos parado de darle tiempo a Dios. Si él es nuestro amigo fiel, si él es Jesús, tu fiel amigo, si él es tu mejor amigo, tu Dios, si dices tener una relación con él, aleluya, ¿por qué estás descuidando tiempo con él? Dice la palabra del Señor que vendrá un tiempo donde ya no será hallado, amén. En aquel día muchos le dirán, Señor, Señor, aleluya, mas él les dirá, apartaos de mí, no os conozco. ¿Por qué? Porque no había nada de esto. No había oración, no había lectura. ¿Cómo puedes decir que le conoces y que él te conoce si no le estás dando tiempo? ¿Cómo quieres que Dios te quite esos temores? Aleluya, que te quite esos problemas si no le estás dando tiempo, si no le conoces. Es como pedirle ayuda a un extranjero que no te conoce en muchas ocasiones. Casi el 90% será difícil que ellos confíen en ti para darte esa ayuda. How do you expect God to help you fight those battles? How do you expect God to take away those fears, those trials and tribulations if he probably doesn't know you right now? If you're not seeking him, if you do not know his word, how do you expect that? It's like asking help from a stranger, amen, asking him for a large amount of money or help in any area. He's going to be skeptical because he does not know you. Hallelujah. It is time for us to draw near with a willing heart, because the word of God says that God, it is important for us to humble ourselves to God, because his word says that God does not neglect a humble and contrite heart. Es necesario acercarnos a él humildemente, humillándonos a él, porque dice la palabra que Dios no desecha, aleluya, aleluya, a alguien que tiene un corazón contrito y humilde. Aleluya. Dios quiere darte paz. Dios quiere ayudarte. Dios quiere, aleluya, que tú habites bajo su abrigo. Pero a veces preferimos salir del abrigo y habitar en otros lugares. Holy Spirit. A lot of times, God wants us to dwell under his shadow, amen. He wants to protect us, but a lot of times we leave that covering and we rather seek that covering in other places. Amen. Seeking help in places, seeking help, amen, in other things. Seeking help in counsel from ungodly things. God is telling you, it is time for you to return to my word. It is time for God's people to believe his word, to do the same thing that Jehoshaphat did. The Bible says that when those armies came against the people of God, they tried to put fear in him. Remember that. They sent a letter to him and they told him, behold, the Moabites, the Ammonites, the Amalekites, amen, the Ammonites and everybody, they came against God and they told them, behold, we have raised up an army to battle against thee. They try to put fear, they try to tell him, they told him, the Bible says that it says a large army is coming against you and your people, trying to put fear in him. And what's the first beautiful example that we saw? First, we see that Jehoshaphat, being 100% man, fear fell upon him. Oh, I feel God's presence. But what did he do? He started to seek God. And he made a fast and a prayer with all of God's people. He gathered them together in the council to start praying and seeking God. Look how powerful the word of God is, that it gives us examples of what we are to do when fear comes upon us. Aleluya, mira la palabra del Señor. Dice allí, donde estábamos leyendo en Segunda de Crónicas 20, que cuando vinieron estas naciones contra el pueblo de Dios, que le mandaron esa letra, amén, le dijeron: he aquí los moabitas, amalequitas, los amonitas, aleluya, los moabitas, todos, una gran, primero le dicen, una gran, aleluya, un gran ejército viene contra ti y tu pueblo, contra el pueblo de Dios. Pero mira qué hermoso ejemplo vemos primero, como un recordatorio. Dice que empezaron a buscar a Dios. Primero podemos ver, aleluya, como Josafat, siendo 100% hombre, le entró temor en su corazón. Dice que el temor cayó sobre él. ¿Y qué empezó a hacer él? Él sabía que él no podía con sus propias fuerzas. Él supo que era imposible que él pudiera hacer algo. Aleluya. Y él empezó a buscar a Dios. Dice la palabra que hicieron ayuno en oración con todo el concilio y empezaron a inquirir a Dios. Dice la palabra. They knew that he knew that he could do nothing. They knew that they were incapable to do this, to be able to defeat this army. Hallelujah. But they started to seek God because they knew how great their God was. Ellos sabían qué poderoso y maravilloso, omnipotente era su Dios. Y mira qué hermoso que vino la palabra de Jehová a ellos, a Josafat, y le dijo al pueblo: no es necesario que salgáis a pelear, porque yo pelearé con vosotros. Aleluya. Look how powerful it was that God, the word of the Lord, came to them and told them, there is no need for you to go out and fight. Hallelujah. Because I, the Lord of hosts, hallelujah, will fight for you. I feel God's presence. It is not by might. It is not by power. But by his spirit, saith the Lord. No es con espada, ni con ejército, pero más con su santo espíritu. Le dijo David a Goliat en aquel día. Él no le importó el tamaño de Goliat. No le importó el tamaño de ese problema. Él se acercó. Aleluya. No le importó que Goliat se riera de él. ¿Quién es este niño? Dijo Goliat, riéndose de él. Oh, santo, yo siento tu presencia. Oh, pero David, conociendo quién era su Dios, reconociendo, aleluya, que el Dios Todopoderoso iba delante de él, el Dios Todopoderoso que no conoce la derrota, el Dios Todopoderoso que creó los cielos y la tierra, aleluya, que dice la palabra, aleluya, que él habita en el cielo y la tierra es el estrado donde él pone los pies. Oh, poder de Dios, hay poder en su santo nombre. Dijo: ¿quién es este incircunciso? Aleluya, dijo él, aleluya, tú vienes contra mí con espada y jabalina, mas yo vengo contra ti en el nombre todopoderoso del Dios omnipotente. Y él pudo vencer, un niño, un joven niño pudo vencer a ese gigante enorme. Praise the living God. I feel the presence of the Lord. Oh, when David came against Goliath, hallelujah, he did not care of the size of this man. Hallelujah, the Bible describes, hallelujah, Goliath, that he was 9 foot tall. He was one of the, hallelujah, the Philistines' greatest warrior at that time. Hallelujah. He was taunting God's people. And David wasn't having none of that. He stepped out on faith, believing God's word. This is the same man, I feel the presence of God. The same man that wrote that psalm that we were writing. He who dwells in the secret place. Hallelujah. The shadow, that means that he already knew. He believed the word of God. He was filled with the Holy Spirit. Praise God. And listen, the word of God says that he came. He stood before Goliath. He did not care the size of this man. He said, who is this uncircumcised man? Who is this uncircumcised man? Hallelujah. Goliath laughed at him. He said, I'm gonna crush you, boy. But he did not care. He knew, David knew that his God was the Almighty, creator of the heavens and the earth. He that sitteth on the throne. He stood before that giant, and he told them, you come against me. You're coming against me with a sword. Hallelujah, with a spear. But I come to you in the name of the Father. Hallelujah, in the name of the Lord of hosts. And he was able to slay that giant. It was through his faith. It was through him believing the God that he served. Believing that the Almighty God, hallelujah, the God that has been preached about for thousands of years, he is alive. He is not dead, and he's coming back soon. God wants to instill faith in you and remind you that he is with you. He is with you, but it is necessary for you to believe in his word. Job said, though he slay me, yet will I trust in him, because he knew that whatever was happening to him, hallelujah, was for a purpose, because he that created a good work in you shall finish it. Oh, dijo Job, por medio de la palabra, aunque él me matare, todavía yo confiaré en él, porque ellos reconocían, estos varones de Dios, reconocían, aleluya, que el Dios Todopoderoso, entendían cuál era el Dios que ellos predicaban, profesaban, en el Dios que ellos creían. Es necesario de empezar a creer a la palabra del Señor, porque dice la palabra, así como José, como Abraham, como Moisés fueron justificados por la fe, por medio de la fe, just like this man Moses, Abraham, Joseph, all the men of ancient, all the prophets, hallelujah, all the men of God that we read about through this word, they were justified by faith. It is necessary to believe. Oh, I feel your presence, Father God. Stephen was stoned to death for preaching the gospel, but he knew the God that he believed. It was so much the faith that he had in God, in the God that he preached, in the God that he knew, in the God that would speak to him, the God that he prayed to. It was so much the faith that he had, that even in his deathbed, even while they were stoning him, he was able to see the glory of God. He said, behold, I see the Lord in the clouds, and Jesus sitting at the right hand of the Father. Era tanta la fe, aleluya, y la confianza que Esteban tenía en el Señor, que aún en su lecho de muerte, aún en ese momento, él pudo creer por medio de la fe. Era tanta su fe en la palabra de Dios. Oh, yo quisiera morir así un día. Yo le pido al Señor, si un día muero, Señor, permíteme morir como Esteban, predicando tu palabra, porque era tanta la fe de Esteban que aún allí, cuando estaba siendo apedreado, él pudo decir, oh santo, siento tu presencia, Dios mío. Él pudo decir, he aquí, miro al Señor sentado en el trono y Cristo a su diestra. Oh santo es el Señor, el que habita al abrigo del Altísimo, morará bajo la sombra y tacabasaya. Oh, morará bajo la sombra del Omnipotente. He who dwells in the shelter of the Almighty shall rest in the shadow. Aleluya. Shall rest in the shadow of the Almighty, El Shaddai, omnipotent, all powerful God, El Shaddai, omnipotente, Dios todopoderoso, el que vive y reina por siempre, el que es, el que será y el que ha de venir. He who was, he who is, he who was, and he that cometh. Hallelujah. He said in his word, I am Alpha and Omega, beginning and end. Cristo dijo en su palabra, yo soy Alfa y Omega, aleluya, principio y el fin. Dios te está hablando. God is speaking to you. It is time for us to begin to believe in his word. Because surely he's coming soon. Hallelujah. The day of the Lord draweth nigh. God is the same yesterday and today forevermore. That's what excites me the most. I am so excited when I read the word of God, because I know the God. God that I serve. I serve the same God that Jacob served. I serve the same God that Moses served. Oh, I feel your presence, my God. I serve the same God that Joseph served. I serve the same God of Jeremiah. I'm serving the same God of Peter. I serve the same God, oh, that spoke to Paul on the road to Damascus. That is our God. The same yesterday, today, and forevermore. Malachi 3:6. For I, the Lord, I change not. I do not change. Hebrews 13:8. Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. Oh, la palabra del Señor. Aleluya, me excita. Porque yo siento, aleluya, gozo en mi alma. Siento gozo por medio de su palabra. Yo siento el gozo del Señor. Porque el mismo Dios de Moisés, el mismo Dios de Abraham, el mismo Dios de Jacob, el mismo Dios de Jeremías, de Pedro, el mismo Dios que paró a Pablo cuando él iba, aleluya, para Damasco. Ese es mi Dios, el mismo Dios que no cambia. Malaquías 3:6, porque yo, el Señor Dios Todopoderoso, no cambio. Hebreos 13:8, Cristo es el mismo ayer y hoy y para siempre. Dios no ha cambiado su palabra. El cielo y la tierra pasará, mas su palabra no pasará. Heaven and earth shall pass, but my words will not pass, saith the Lord. Hallelujah. His word is everlasting. His word is true. His word is faithful. Su palabra es fiel. El Señor es poderoso. Bendito sea su santo nombre. Blessed be the name of the Lord of hosts. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. Leave that fear at his feet. Deja ese temor que te atormenta, déjalo a sus pies. Aleluya, santo eres, Dios mío, santo. Dijo el salmista, aleluya. Oh, Dios todopoderoso, el ángel de Jehová acampa alrededor de los que le temen y los defiende. Oh, the word of God says, the angel of the Lord encampeth round about them that fear him and delivereth them. Oh, I feel the presence of God. Hallelujah. I sought the Lord. I began to seek the Lord and he heard me and he delivered me from all of my fears. Busqué a Jehová, busqué a Jehová, oh, busqué a Jehová, y él me oyó y me libró de todos mis temores. Me libró de todos, no nomás de uno, no nomás de un poco, pero de todos mis temores. He delivered me from all of my fears, all of them, not just one, not just a portion of fears. He freed me from all of my fears. What the word of God says. God is good. The eyes of the Lord are upon the righteous, and his ears are open unto their cry. Oh, powerful word of God. Los ojos de Jehová están sobre los justos y atentos sus oídos al clamor de ellos. Hay poder en su santo nombre. Bendito sea el Dios Todopoderoso. God is good. God is good. God is good. God is telling you. God is calling you. Turn from your evil ways. Turn from your sinning ways. God is calling you. He's a gentleman. He wants to change you. He wants to take that alcoholism from your life. He wants to free you from drug addiction. He wants to free you from a lot of things that torment your life. But it is time for you to make a decision. Choose this day whom ye shall serve. Why do you trouble yourselves with that? ¿Por qué claudicáis con vuestros, aleluya, por qué claudicáis en vuestros pensamientos? Decidid, escoged hoy a quién servirás, dice el Señor. Mas yo y mi casa y yo serviremos al Señor. But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Hallelujah. God is calling you. Dios te llama. Cristo te llama. Es tiempo de volverte de ese pecado que te atormenta. Ese alcoholismo, esa drogadicción. Ese pecado que atormenta tu vida. Esos temores, esas opresiones, Dios te llama. Arrepentíos y creed del Evangelio. Es necesario arrepentirnos de nuestros pecados para recibir ese perdón corredentor. It is necessary for us to repent and believe the gospel to be able to receive, hallelujah, that redeeming, hallelujah, sacrifice, that redeeming power, amen. God is near to those that seek him with all their hearts. Dios está cerca a todo aquel que le busca de todo corazón. God is good. Thank you, Jesus. We worship you. I want to make a call out there to anybody that wants to reconcile with the Lord. Quiero hacer un llamado a todo aquel que quiera, amén, reconciliarse con el Señor. Those that do not know the Lord, maybe you're saying, I want to experience that peace, that security, that I want to find refuge. You've been seeking refuge and security in other things that do not last. Amen. But God is telling you, give it all to me. Give me your heart. Give me your heart. Muchos que no conocen al Señor que dicen, Señor, yo quiero experimentar ese refugio en ti. Quiero refugiarme en ti. Poderoso es el Señor. Dios bendiga a todos los que nos están viendo. Amén. Oyendo. Amén. Amén. Dios te bendiga, Angelita Portillo. Hay poder. Ahí está la palabra del Señor. Sigue hablando. Jehová es mi luz y mi salvación. ¿De quién temeré? Jehová es la fortaleza de mi vida. ¿De quién he de atemorizarme? Hay poder en su palabra. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Of whom shall I fear? Hallelujah. God's word is alive. God's word is alive. Amen. Amén. Ezequiel, Dios te bendiga, siervo. Dios es necesario. Acuérdate, Hebreos 10:25 dice, amén, y no dejando de congregarnos como algunos tienen por costumbre. Es necesario que tú busques una iglesia, amén, donde tú te encuentres, una iglesia de sana doctrina, donde tú puedas crecer en la palabra del Señor, amén. Puesto los ojos en Jesús, el autor y consumador de la fe. Hebrews 10:25, amén, we got people commenting, amén. Amen, we're going to pray. Claudia, Veronica, amen, that's family right there. Amen, we're definitely going to be praying. We're still praying. We're still praying. My wife, we always lift you guys up in prayer. Amen. And asking the Lord that he can lift you up. Amen. And you know, we believe that the Lord has a calling upon your life. Amen. Jarrell Mitchell, pray for me. I always need prayer. I got you, my brother. Please pray for us as well. Amen. As we begin to get ready to wrap it up, I think the Lord has spoke to us. Estamos a punto de cerrar esta sesión. Amén. Creo que el Señor nos ha hablado. Quiero que ores esta oración conmigo. Alguien que quiera reconciliarse con el Señor. Alguien que no conoce al Señor. Amén. I want you to say this prayer with me. Saludos desde Guatemala. Douglas José. Dios te bendiga, siervo. Te amamos en el Señor. Comparte este video. Alguien, aleluya, necesita escuchar esta palabra. El que habita al abrigo del Altísimo morará bajo la sombra del Omnipotente. We got greetings from Guatemala, the country, amen, of Guatemala. Praise God. I'm filled with joy when we hear that people are being touched all over the world. Mi corazón se llena de gozo cuando vemos que su palabra está llegando, aleluya, a otros países, amen. El Señor es bueno. Gracias, mi hermano Douglas, por comentar. Dios te bendiga. Bendiciones. Bobby, amen. God bless you, my brother. Prayers for your wife, amen. Growth and deliverance, amen, my brother. Amen. We're definitely going to be praying. Amen. I want everybody to just stretch your hands toward this, amen, this your screen, amen, where you're watching. And we're going to pray for those that want to reconcile with the Lord, those that want to fix their relationship with the Lord, amen. Those that do not know the Lord, we're going to do this prayer, amen. Vamos a orar. Quiero que todos extiendan sus manos ahí donde se encuentran viéndonos en vivo, amen. Vamos a orar, amen, por las almas que quieren reconciliarse con el Señor y por las almas que no conocen al Señor, amen, que quieren aceptar a Cristo como su Señor Salvador personal, amen. Vamos a estar así como lo estamos haciendo en bilingüe, how we're doing it bilingual. We're going to, amen, go ahead and do this prayer bilingual first, English and Spanish, or however we're going to do this, amen. I want you to close your eyes and say, Lord Jesus, I come before you. recognizing that I'm a sinner in need of a Savior. I believe that you died for me and that you rose on the third day to forgive me of my sins. I receive your salvation. Come into my heart and reign in my life. Holy Spirit, cover me. From this day forward, I choose to follow Christ. Amen. Vamos a orar esta oración. Amén. Cierra tus ojos y di amén. Poderoso el Señor. Cierra tus ojos. Di, Señor Jesús, vengo delante de ti. Reconociendo que soy un pecador, necesito un Salvador. Entra en mi corazón y reina en mi vida. Yo creo que moriste por mí en la cruz y que al resucitar al tercer día lo hiciste para salvar mi alma del infierno. Acepto tu salvación en mi vida y séllame con tu Espíritu Santo. Desde este momento en adelante yo decido seguir a Cristo. Cristo dijo en su palabra, aleluya, si alguno viene en pos de mí, niéguese a sí mismo, levante su cruz y sígame. Jesus said in his word, if any man come to follow me, he said, let him deny himself first, pick up his cross and follow me. Let me pray for you. Father God, in the name of Jesus, I thank you, Father God, for this session, for everyone that was tuned in, Father God, to hear your word of God, Father. I feel their love, Lord, and I know that your word, Father God, does not come back void. All those that prayed that sinner's prayer, Father God, I believe those that reconciled with you and those, Father, that are new, Lord, that they accepted you as Savior, Lord, for the first time. Cover them with your precious blood. Be with them. Help them find a good church where they can go, Father, and receive your word. Espíritu Santo, todas las personas que entonizaron con nosotros, Dios mío, y todos los que hicieron esa oración de fe, Dios mío, para aceptarte como Salvador en su vida, Dios mío, que seas tú, Dios mío, cuidándolos, sellándolos. Te pido por sus familias, Dios mío, que ellos puedan encontrar, Dios mío, una iglesia, Dios mío, que tú los guíes, Dios mío, omnipresente. Guíalos a una buena iglesia donde ellos puedan ir a recibir y crecer en ti, porque tú vienes pronto. Gracias, Señor, te damos la honra y la gloria, te exaltamos. Thank you, Lord Jesus. We worship you and we praise you. We pray this all in the mighty name of Christ. Amen and amen. Alabado sea el Señor. Thank you, everybody, for tuning in with us today. I'm so excited. Amen. This has been the radio and podcast station, God of Wonders, Holy Life Radio. Esta ha sido, amén, estación de radio, Dios de Proezas, Vida Santa. Amén. Estamos agradecidos, amén. Yo quisiera que nos escriban, amén. I would like for you guys to write, reach out to us, amen. You can reach out to us through email, godofwondersradiopodcast@gmail.com. Pueden escribirnos, amén, por medio del correo electrónico que se escribe en inglés, godofwonders, G-O-D-D-E, dice W-O-N-D-E-R-S. radiopodcast@gmail.com. It's God of Wonders Radio Podcast. Amen. And we want to hear from you. We want to hear from you and any testimonies if God has done something in your life through this medium. Amen. We want you guys to go ahead and reach out to us. That encourages us. Nos anima que nos escriban. Amen. Ahí siempre recibimos ahí peticiones. Amen. If you have prayer requests, also, amen, we want you guys to reach out to us, and we definitely want to be able to be a blessing through this medium, amen, through this ministry. God is good, amen. This is your brother in Christ, Tony Vasquez Jr. Este es tu hermano y servidor, Tony Vasquez Jr., amen. Y estamos creyendo lo que la palabra del Señor dice. Dios es bueno, amen, y Dios se mueve por medio de su palabra. Dios nos habla, creo que el Señor nos ha hablado a todos. Amén. Y estamos agradecidos por su palabra, por su espíritu. Amén. I want you guys to reach out to us. Nosotros estamos, ahorita nos tiene el Señor en la ciudad de Richmond, California. Amén. We are currently in the city of Richmond. California. Estamos en la iglesia pentecostal, Iglesia de Dios Pentecostal MI, Movimiento Internacional, que es la dirección es 830 McDonald Avenida, Richmond, California, 94801. Amén, ahí están los pastores Galván, amén, y un pueblo de Dios hermoso, amén, que los ama y los recibe, amén, con amor. Te esperamos si estás en esta área. We're in the city of Richmond, California. We're in the Pentecostal Church of God, MI, International Movement. We're located at 830 McDonald Avenue, Richmond, California, 94801. And yeah, we're there, we're there with pastors Pedro Galvan and his wife, amen. And there's a beautiful church, amen, of brothers and sisters in the faith that receive you with open arms and the love of Christ, amen. And we're waiting for you if you are in the area, the San Francisco Bay Area, amen. And we love you. We're praying for you, amen. And we hope that you can keep us in prayer, amen, that the word of God, that the gospel be spread through this medium. Les amamos en el Señor, pidiéndoles oraciones por nosotros, amén, que podamos seguir por medio de este medio, amén, predicando la palabra del Señor, amén. Y así con eso los dejamos, amén, los dejo, será hasta luego, amén, y estaremos en comunión orando los unos por los otros, amén, así como el apóstol Pablo nos enseñó, amén, está en Efesios capítulo 6, versículo 18, si no me equivoco. Amén. Creo que este es, no, o oh, si sí es, ok. Dice, orando en todo tiempo, con toda oración y súplica en el Espíritu, y velando en ello con toda perseverancia y súplica por todos los santos. Amén. The Word of God says, amen, right there in Ephesians chapter 6, verse 18. Praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, and watching thereunto with all perseverance and supplication for all the saints. Amen. And we'll be praying for you, amen. All the prayer requests will definitely be keeping everybody updated, with our next radio and podcast. And we thank you all for everybody that's been tuned in. You've been great, amen. Thank you for your comments. Thank you for your encouraging, loving words, amen. Le agradecemos a todos los que estaban ahí entonizando con nosotros, amén, comentando allí, dando palabras de ánimo, amén. Es mi deseo poder ser de edificación y bendición al pueblo. It is our desire to be able to be a blessing and to be able to edify the people of God, amen. Amen. Praise the Lord, Brother Bobby. Amen. You're in San Francisco. Come give us a visit one day, man. Dios les bendiga a todos, amén. Dios es bueno, amén. Le agradecemos al Señor por este tiempo. Así vamos a estar cerrando con una oración. Amén. Para cerrar, we'll be closing with a word of prayer. Amén. Para darle gracias al Señor por este tiempo. Thanking God for this time that He has given us. Amen. Let us bow our heads and pray. Amen. Father, we come before you one more time, Father God. Just giving you thanks, Father God, for this medium, Father God, for showing up, Holy Spirit, and speaking to us. We thank you for your word, for everything that you have spoken unto us, Father God. It is you that speaks to your people. It is your word that convicts us, Father God. I thank you, Father God. I pray for everyone, Father God, that's tuned in with us, Father God, that we be a blessing, Lord, and that we continue to persevere, Father God, until your coming, Father. Te damos las gracias, Señor, la honra y la gloria por todos los que entonizan con nosotros, Dios mío. Que tú los bendigas, Dios mío. Y que podamos seguir en comunión, perseverando, amén, hasta que tú regreses, Padre. Te damos la honra y la gloria y te exaltamos, te agradecemos, Espíritu Santo, te agradecemos por tu presencia. Tú eres el que habla, Señor. Te damos la honra y la gloria, poderoso, hermoso Jesús. Amén y amén. Amen. God bless you. We love you in the Lord. Amen. We ask for your prayers, amen. I don't even want to leave, amen, but I got a wife and kids, and we got to go over there and give time. There's a time for everything, amen. Quisiera quedarme, amen, no quiero irme, pero como dije, tengo una esposa y hijos, hijas, amen, y hay un tiempo para todo, amen, y será hasta luego, amen. Les amo en el Señor, Dios me los bendiga. God bless you all, peace and blessings. In Jesus' name, amen.